हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद चैप्टर 2 मेजर लैंडफॉर्म्स। वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मेजर लैंडफॉर्म्स। वी लर्नड अबाउट माउंटेंस एंड प्लेट्यूज एंड द लास्ट टाइप ऑफ लैंडफॉर्म इज प्लेन्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट प्लेन्स। फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट आर प्लेन्स। फ्लैट सरफेस with very gentle slopes are called plains. What is plain? Flat surfaces with very gentle slopes are called plains, and they are leveled land. Plains are leveled lands. There are different types of plains. Plains are found at the bottom of mountains, top of plateaus, and on the beds of large river banks. Where we can see plains. Plains are found at the bottom of mountain, top of plateaus, and on the beds of large river lakes. Means on the bank of rivers. Okay, and I think all of you understood about the definition of plain. What is plain? Flat surface with very gentle slopes are called plain. Where we can see plains, plain areas, at the bottom of mountain, top of plateaus, and on the beds of large river lakes. Okay, and first now we will discuss about different types of plains. First, coastal plains. Coastal means area near the seashores. It is found along the margins of seas and ocean. Coastal plains means the area near the seashore. It is found along the margins of seas and oceans. Second, floodplains are found along the banks of rivers. Where we can see floodplains? Along the banks of river. And next, peneplain. The lowered mountain and plateaus are known as peneplain. Another important term related to it is river basin. What is river basin? When the rivers and winds deposits materials near the rivers and form a land area. What is that? When the rivers and winds deposit or collect materials near the rivers and form a land area called river basin. This is also a way how plains are formed. We will call river basins. This area we will call river basins. Okay, and next, alluvial plains. When the river flows, its deposit materials like sand, silt and clay, which is called alluvium. Plains are formed. That is known as alluvial plains. When the river flows, at the time of flow, when the rivers flows, river deposit materials like sand, silt and clay. It is called alluvium. Then plains are formed. That is known as alluvial plains. When it is formed by the sudden increase in the volume of water. It causes the formation of plains. So it is known as floodplain. Okay. And now we will learn about the importance of plains. What are the importance of plains? They are very fertile. Plains are very fertile, very good for cultivation. We can easily grow crops in plain areas. And trade flourishes here. These areas are very good for trade because it is easy to make roads in this area. In plain area, it is very easy to make roads. So trade flourishes. These plains are very good for trading. traits. Okay, and this is also a most populated area. Plains are the most populated area. Many people likes to live in plain area. Okay, comparatively better than mountain area. Okay, these are the importance of plains. If the plains are very fertile, trade plains are very good for trade, and this area is most populated area. Okay, and now we will see the life in mountain and life in plains. Difference between life in mountain and life in plains. All of you know that the life in plain is very easy comparatively mountains, isn't it? Now we will see life in mountain. There are usually cold area. These are usually cold area. Mountain area are usually cold area. Hard to grow crops. Very difficult to grow crops. Crops are planted in the method of terrace farming. Crops are planted in the method of terrace farming. Another important work of the people is rearing of sheep and goats. These are the main work for the people, those who are living in mountain, rearing animals. And houses are made here with wood and stone. Traveling in this area is very difficult. Most people are farmers. Other work in power this area and here we can see many kinds of power plants and mines. And this is a good area for tourism. That is the important thing. Mountain area, hilly area are very good for tourism. Okay, now we will see the life in plains. The life here is very easy. It is good to grow crops. Plains are very fertile area and it is very good to grow crops because land is very fertile. People also rear animals. Transportation is very easy here, like roads, waterways and railways. Here also have large and small town. In plain area we can see large and small towns. Most people are farmers and others work in factories, offices, shops and so on. These are the major important difference between life in mountain and life in plains. So our here we are concluding the lesson. Now we are going to do the remaining exercises. Question number A, fourth one. What is a plain? What is a plain? Answer is page number 50. The first title, plains. Flat surfaces with very gentle slopes are called plains. Flat surfaces with very gentle slopes are called plains. Okay, and question number 5. Write two ways of earning a living in the mountain. Write two ways of earning a living in the mountain. Answer is page number 17. Page number 17. Mountain people can earn a living by running hotels, shops and restaurants, by arranging transport and adventure activities for tourists and by selling handicrafts. Mountains people can earn a living by running hotels, shops and restaurants, by arranging transport and adventure activities for tourists and by selling handicraft. This is the answer of question number 5. And next we will see the distinguish between the following. Question number B5. A coastal plain and flood plain. Okay, coastal plain and flood plain. Answer is page number 80. Coastal plain. Page number 18, things to remember. One box is there, no points to remember. The last coastal plain is a plain located along the margin of an ocean or a sea. Floodplain, a plain located along the bank of a river. Okay, this is the answer of B5. Okay, and question number C. How are alluvial plains formed? How are alluvial plains formed? Answer is page number 16. Page number 16. When the rivers reach gentle slopes, they slow down and start depositing the material. The deposited material comprising sand, silt and clay is called alluvium. Thus, the plain formed by rivers are called alluvial plains. This is the answer of question number C3. And question number 4. Why do most people live on plains? Why do most people live on plains? Answer is page number 17. Page number 17. Plains are generally very fertile. Plains are generally very fertile and many kinds of crops, including most of our food crops, are grown on them. And next paragraph, roads and railways can be built easily on level land and it is easy to travel and to transport goods. Then one more sentence we need. There are many factories, offices and shops. So people can find a variety of jobs. This is the answer of question number C4. Okay. And here I am adding question number D and E. Here are the answer of D and E. Those who are not completed till now, please see and write in your textbook. And lesson 2, all of you, please prepare for your revision test. Okay, children. Thank you.